Good morning to everyone. Myself, B. Thulasi Koteswari Bai, lecturer in chemistry, Sir CRR College for Women, Eluru. I am dealing the subject chemistry for semester 5, paper 5A. Title is Inorganic, Organic and Physical Chemistry. In this video, I am explaining the topic Crystal Field Theory, Part 1. Crystal Field Theory, Part 1. In this topic, I am explaining the key points, introduction, postulates, splitting of d orbitals in octahedral complexes, filling up of d orbitals in strong ligands, filling up of d orbitals in case of weak ligands. Introduction. Crystal Field Theory is very much different from the valence bond theory. We know that according to valence bond theory, the bond between metal ion and ligand is purely covalent. That is, bond formed by the sharing of electrons. But according to crystal field theory, the interaction between metal ion and ligands, both of which acts as point charges. That is, it is purely electrostatic. That is, the bond between metal and ligand is 100% ionic. So, crystal field theory is different from valence bond theory. According to valence bond theory, bond between metal and ligand is formed by the sharing of electrons. But according to crystal field theory, the bond between metal and ligand is formed by the transfer of electrons. So, which is ionic bond, 100% ionic bond. This theory was expounded by H. Bethe and Black to explain the mainly color and magnetic properties of crystalline solids. Hence, it is named as crystal field theory. This theory mainly explains the color and magnetic properties of coordination compounds. The main postulates of this theory are, first postulate, according to crystal field theory, the metal ion is situated in an electric field caused by surrounding molecules or ions called ligands. That is, metal is situated in the electric field caused by the surrounding molecules or ions. That surrounding molecules are called ligands. The ligands, which are either negatively charged or neutral molecules, can donate an electron pair to the metal ion and produce a field approximately equivalent to that of a set of negative point charges. That is, ligands create a field which is equivalent to negative point charges. And metals are generally electropositive. So, there may be electrostatic force of attraction. So, the bond between metal and ligand is 100% ionic. Thus, it is the interaction of d orbitals of the transition metal with the ligands surrounding the metal that produces the crystal field effects. In metal, the d orbitals interact with the ligand orbitals and produces a crystal field effects. Hence, in order to understand CFT, it is necessary to recapitulate the shapes of 5d orbitals. There are 5d orbitals. The shapes of these 5 orbitals are, first of all, these 5 orbitals are dxy, dxz, dyz, dx square minus y square and dz square. Out of these 5d orbitals, the first 3d orbitals dxy, dzx and dyz are having the lobes in between the axes. That is, dxy orbital is having lobes in between x and y axis. And dzx orbital is having the lobes in between z and x axis. And the third orbital, dyz orbital, is having the lobes in between y and z orbitals. Though for these three orbitals, the lobes are in between the coordinate axis. For other two d orbitals, that is dx square minus y square and dz square, the lobes are on the axis. That is, for dx square minus y square, the lobes are on x and y axis. For dz square orbital, the lobes are on main electron density is present on the z axis, on the axis. So these five orbitals are having the similar shape, but their orientation is different. These are having double dumbbell shape, but the first three d orbitals, that is dxy, dzx and dyz orbitals, are having the lobes in between the axis, and the other two d orbitals are having the lobes on the axis. Of the five d orbitals, three, namely dxy, dxz and dyz, have maximum electron density, that is the lobes are maximum electron density directed between x, y and z axis. The set of these orbitals is collectively known as T2g or d epsilon orbitals. And the other two d orbitals, that are the dz square orbital, has maximum electron density along z axis, while the dx square minus y square orbital has maximum electron density along x and y axis. These two orbitals, that is dz square and dx square minus y square, together are known as eg or d gamma orbitals. So 5d orbitals are grouped into two groups. First 3d orbitals are known as t2g or d epsilon. The other two are known as eg or d gamma orbitals. In every free metal ion, the 5d orbitals have the same energy, so they are known as degenerate orbitals. But however, on the approach of ligands, the d electrons will be repelled by the lone pair of electrons of the ligands, leading to the increase in the energy level of the d orbitals. That is, when the free metal ion, in the free metal ion, the 5d orbitals have same energy, that is these are degenerate. When ligands approaches the metal, then the d electrons of the metal will interact with the lone pair of electrons of the ligand. Hence, due to the repulsion, the energy of the d electrons, d orbitals, increases. Now suppose all the approaching ligands are at an equal distance from the each of the d orbitals, then in such a case, energy of each d orbital will increase by the same amount. That is, all the approaching ligands are at equal distance from the d orbitals, then the increase in energy will be the same amount. And thus, the 5d orbitals will still remain degenerate, although they have now higher energy than before. However, this is only an imaginary situation, because d orbitals are not spherically symmetrical and they differ in their orientation. So, in practice, the energy of the orbitals lying in the direction of the ligands is raised to larger extent, as they will be more repelled by the ligands than the orbitals lying in between the ligands. That is, the d orbitals which are in the direction of the ligands will repel to the more extent than in between the axes. Thus, under the influence of ligands, the 5 degenerate d orbitals of the metal ion will split into two groups of orbitals of different energy. This effect is known as crystal field splitting. That is, when ligands approaches the metal ion, the 5d orbitals of the metal will split into two groups with different energies. This splitting is known as crystal field splitting, or also known as energy level splitting. The crystal field splitting will be different in different structures with different coordination numbers. Now let us see the splitting of d orbitals in octahedral complexes. What are octahedral complexes? In octahedral complexes, there are 6 ligands are present. This is the central metal. These 6 are ligands. These ligands, consider these ligands are present on the axis. These 2 ligands are on the x-axis. These 2 are in the y-axis. These 2 ligands are on the x-axis. And these 2 ligands are on the z-axis, indicated by here. So, in the center, there is a metal ion. These ligands are arranged in the axis, on the axis for octahedral complexes. So, in an octahedral complex, the coordination number is 6. For simplicity, consider the 6 ligands approach the metal ion along the axis of the coordinate system. Then, now since the 2 of the 5 d orbitals, that is dx square minus y square and dz square, collectively known as eg or d gamma orbitals, are oriented along the axis. The ligands are also along the axis, so they will be repelled more than the remaining 3 d orbitals, that is txy, dyz and dzx, collectively known as T2gr d epsilon orbitals, because these directed between the approaching ligands. That is, when ligands approaches the metal ion octahedrally, then the eg orbitals are on the axis, ligands are also on the axis, so they will be repelled more. But T2g orbitals are oriented in between the axis, ligands are on the axis, so T2g orbitals will be repelled less. Hence, the energy of the 2 eg orbitals increases much more than the energy of T2g orbitals. Thus, the 5d orbitals split into 2 groups of different energies. The energy difference between T2g and eg orbitals is commonly known as crystal field splitting, and it is denoted by the symbol delta or delta O, the subscript O indicating for octahedral complex. Sometimes delta O is replaced by 10dg. This is the splitting. In the state 1, the metal is in the free state. So, these 5d orbitals are having the same energy. These are degenerate. When ligands approaches the metal spherically, that is from the equal distance, then there will be repulsion between ligands and the metal ion. So, the energy of these orbitals increases. This is shown by state 2. This is the energy level indication. From bottom to top, energy level increases. In the state 1, metal is in the free state, so 5d orbitals are having similar energy, that is degenerate. When ligands approaches the metal spherically, then there will be repulsion. Hence, the energy of these 5d orbitals increases to same extent, that is represented by state 2. But this is not the case always. Ligands approaches octahedrally, that is ligands are on the axis. Then the 2 eg orbitals which are oriented along the axis will have more repulsion. Hence their energy increases. And the T2g orbitals are oriented in between the axis, so they will have less repulsion from the ligand, so their energy decreases. So, the 5d orbitals are split into 2 different groups, T2g and eg. The difference between these 2 energy levels is known as crystal field splitting, which is represented by delta. This subscript O represents the octahedral complexes. From the above figure, it is clear that the electrons will tend to occupy T2g orbitals. Lower energy, these are lower energy orbitals in order to achieve stability. Each electron entering the T2g orbital stabilizes the complex ion by a value 0.4 delta or 4 dq units. And each electron entering the higher energy Eg orbital destabilizes the complex ion by 0.6 delta or 6 dq units. That is, in this picture, T2g orbitals are in the lower energy level and Eg orbitals in the higher energy level. When electron enters into the T2g orbital, it stabilizes the complex. When electron enters into the Eg orbital, it destabilizes the complex. When each electron enters into the T2g orbital, it stabilizes the complex by energy 0.4 delta. When electron enters into the Eg orbital, it destabilizes the complex by an energy 0.6 delta. So, the stabilization energy in two cases is represented by 0.4 delta and minus 0.6 delta. Minus is for destabilizing the complex. So, the gain in energy achieved by preferential filling up of orbitals by electrons is known as crystal field stabilization energy, or CFSE. That is, when these T2g and Eg orbitals are filled by electrons, then there is a gain in energy. That energy is known as crystal field stabilization energy. Simply, it is represented by CFSE. The greater the amount of CFSE of the complex, the greater is the stability of the complex. Now, filling up of d orbitals. Let us see the filling up of d orbitals. When the first, second and third electron enter the d orbital, they occupy the three T2g orbitals one by one. However, when the fourth and next electron enters the d orbitals, two opposite options are available for the electron. However, the exact path chosen by the electron depends upon the strength of the ligand. That is, first option is in presence of strong ligands. Strong ligands like CO, CN-, etc. The fourth electron pairs up in the T2g, lower energy orbital, because delta O is large, crystal field splitting is large. So, the fourth electron does not go to Eg orbital in case of strong ligands. So, it is forced to paired up in the T2g orbital. Thus, in presence of strong ligand field, low spin complexes, that is diamagnetic complexes, are formed. Second option is in presence of weak ligands like F-, H2O, etc., delta O is not large enough. So, not large enough for forcing the pairing up of electron. So, the fourth and fifth electron will enter the Eg orbitals. Thus, in the presence of weak ligand field, high spin paramagnetic complexes are formed. Now, let us see the filling up of d orbitals in case of octahedral complexes in presence of strong ligand field. In presence of strong ligands, crystal field splitting delta value is more. So, fourth electron does not go to the Eg orbital. It pairs up in the T2g orbital. Now, let us study the one by one. The number of electrons in the metal ion is 1. Then it goes to T2g orbital. Then its energy becomes 0.4 delta. The number of unpaired electrons in this case is only 1. When two electrons are present in the d orbital of the metal ion, the first one goes to T2g and second one also goes to T2g orbital. The total energy, the crystal field stabilization energy in this case is 0.4 into 2, which is 0.8 delta. There are two unpaired electrons. When the total number of electrons in the d orbital of the metal ion is 3, then the third electron also goes to T2g orbital. Its energy is 0.4 into 3, which is 1.2 delta. The number of unpaired electrons is 3. Now comes the case. There are 4 electrons in the d orbitals of the metal ion. In case of strong ligand, the fourth electron does not go to Eg orbital, since crystal field stabilization energy is more in presence of strong ligand. So it is paired up in the lower energy T2g orbital. Hence, the CFSE, crystal field stabilization energy, is here there are 4 electrons in the T2g orbital, 4 into 0.4, which is 1.6 delta. But there are only 2 unpaired electron. Then the fifth electron also does not go to Eg orbital, but it is paired up in the T2g orbital. So its energy is 5 into 0.4, which is 2.0 delta. The number of unpaired electrons here is 1. When there are 6 electrons in the d orbital of the metal ion, the 6th electron also does not go to Eg, but it pairs up in the T2g orbital. So 6 into 0.4, the energy is 2.4 delta. There are no unpaired electrons. Now, there are 7 electrons in the d orbital of the metal. There is no space in the T2g orbital. So, the 7th electron goes to Eg orbital. When the electron enters in the Eg orbital, it destabilizes the complex. So, its energy is minus 0.6. When electron goes into the T2g orbital, it stabilizes the complex. That is, here 6 into 0.4 plus 0.4, that is 2.4 minus 0.6, which is equal to 1.8 delta. Here there is one unpaired electron. When there are 8 electrons in the d orbital of the metal ion, then 8th electron goes to the Eg orbital. Here there are 2 electrons in the Eg orbital. When electron goes in the Eg orbital, this destabilizes the complex. That is, its energy is 2 into minus 0.6. That is minus 1.2. Here the energy of the T2g orbital is 6 into 0.4. That is 2.4. Plus 2.4 minus 1.2 gives rise to 1.2 delta. Here there are 2 unpaired electrons. Next, there are 9 electrons in the d orbital of the metal. The 9th electron goes to Eg orbital. It is paired up in the Eg orbital. So its energy is 6 into 0.4, that is 2.4, minus 3 into 0.6, which is equal to minus 1.8. That is, plus 2.4 minus 1.8, which is equal to 0.6 delta. The number of unpaired electrons is 1. When there are 10 electrons, 10th electron pairs up in the Eg orbital, then the energy for T2g orbitals is 6 into 0.4, that is 2.4, minus 4 into 0.6, that is minus 2.4. Plus 2.4 minus 2.4, that is total energy is 0. The number of unpaired electrons is also 0. Now let us see the case of weak ligands. Filling up of d orbitals in octahedral complexes in presence of weak ligands. When the ligand is weak, then the fourth electron goes to Eg orbital, because here the crystal field splitting is less. So the fourth electron goes to Eg orbital. Now let us see one by one. When there is one electron in the d orbital of the metal, it goes to T2g. Its energy is 0.4 delta. Number of unpaired electrons is 1. When there are two electrons, Then the second electron also goes to T2g orbital. Its energy is 0.8 delta. Then number of unpaired electrons is 2. When there are 3 electrons in the d-a orbital of the metal ion, third electron also goes to T2g orbital. Its energy is 1.2 delta. Number of unpaired electrons is 3. When there are fourth electron, since it is a weak ligand, the crystal field splitting is less. So the fourth electron goes to Eg orbital. Then the energy is calculated as, in T2g orbital there are 3 electrons, 3 into 0.4, that is 1.2. Here the when electron enters into Eg orbital, it destabilizes the complex, so its energy is minus 0.6. Plus 1.2 minus 0.6, which is equal to 0.6 delta. Here there are 4 unpaired electrons. When 5 electrons in the metal ion, 5th electron also goes to Eg orbital. Then its energy is, here 3 into 0.4, that is 1.2. Here 2 into minus 0.6, that is minus 1.2. Plus 1.2 minus 1.2, there is the 0.0 energy. But there are number of unpaired electrons are 5. When the 6th electron, when there is a 6 electrons in the d orbital of the metal, 6th electron pairs up in the T2g orbital and its energy is 4 into 0.4, that is 1.6 minus 1.2, which is equal to 0.4 delta. The number of unpaired electrons are 4. When there are 7 electrons in the d orbital of the metal, 7th electron also pairs up in the T2g orbital. Its energy is 5 into 0.4 minus 2 into 0.6, which is 0.8 delta. There are 3 unpaired electrons. When there are 8 electrons, the 8th electron pairs up in the T2g orbital. Its energy is 6 into 0.4, that is plus 2.4 minus 2 into 0.6, which is 1.2. 2.4 minus 1.2, which is equal to 1.2. The number of unpaired electrons is 2. When there are 9 electrons in the d orbital, 9th electron goes to Eg orbital. Then the total energy is 0.4 into 6, that is 2.4 minus 3 into 0.6, which is 1.8. 2.4 minus 1.8 gives 0.6 delta. Number of unpaired electron is 1. When there are 10 electrons, then the 10th electron pairs up in the Eg orbital. Then the energy is 0, since 6 into 0.4 minus 4 into 0.6, total energy is 0. The number of unpaired electrons is also 0. These are the list of reference books for this unit, that is coordination chemistry. Thank you.